Hello and welcome to the Montage Film Review Sunday DVD Rental Suggestion Podcast. Today I have for you a critically acclaimed Mexican movie from the year 2000 in a continuation of our month-long dedication to the cinematic efforts of one Gael Garcia Bernal. Amores Perros, or Love's a Bitch, was the winner of the Palme d'Or at the Cannes Film Festival in the year of its release. During this epic tale of several love affairs that have gone wrong, there is a lot of sex and even more violence. The timeline is curious because it begins with a car crash in Mexico City and then rolls back in time to detail the events leading up to that car crash. However, other movies that have employed this time-bending technique have simply gone back to a point in time and brought the audience into the present. This movie, however, retraces the events leading up to the car crash and then goes beyond that point, shifting its focus from one set of characters to another and the events that occur after the crash. Each of the different sets of characters has a compelling story, and each story is given equal time. Firstly, we have two brothers who still live at home with their mother. One of them is married to a girl still in high school, and they have a child together. Octavio, played by Bernal, is the younger of the two brothers, and he has a thing for his brother's wife. I'm sure there's no need to tell you what that thing is because you can guess for yourself. The older brother works in a supermarket as a full-time job, but he has a little sideline, which is robbing grocery stores. His biggest ambition is to graduate from robbing them to robbing banks, a fantasy that he makes real towards the end of the movie. Whilst he is preoccupied with this, his younger brother begins an affair with his wife in the family home. It is not an act that will ruin their relationship if exposed, because it is already peppered with extreme acts of violence towards each other, and Octavio has a certain amount of contempt for the way that his older brother treats his wife. When he is not pursuing said wife, he enters his dog, a Rottweiler, into local dog fights and makes a hell of a lot of money doing so. This is money that he uses in several different ways in his mission to steal this pregnant woman from his sibling. After the accident, a homeless man pulls the dog from the wreckage and nurses him back to health. The guy has a fondness for dogs, and this is just one more to add to his brood. He seems pretty content with his life until he reads in the newspaper that his wife has died, leading him to try and reconnect with the daughter he abandoned in favour of becoming a failed revolutionary. Since his release from prison, he has been making a living as an assassin for the local community. Jobs are put his way by a local police detective, who was in fact his arresting officer. He is stalking a local businessman on the day of the car crash, and it is for this very reason that he is at the precise location of the accident. This accident occurs when Octavio crashes his car into the car of a model who has been having an affair with a married man. Just prior to the crash, he has left his wife and children and bought her an apartment in which they now both live. The crash is the beginning of a downward spiral for her career as well as their relationship, proving that for these people at least, love is a complicated bitch. This is the first feature film that Gael Garcia Bernal made to enable his transition from television to cinema. It is gritty and hardcore in every sense of those words, and it is not hard to see why it impressed the judges at Cannes. The director, whose name I won't swallow my tongue trying to pronounce, went on to direct and produce the stylish 21 Grams in 2003 and Beautiful in 2010, a film that I really wanted to catch during its theatrical release but sadly missed. As always, I'm your host, Shay Trinity. Thank you for listening to this podcast, which is always an Eskimo Fin production. Please visit www.montagefilmreviews.com, which aims to bring you the very best in film and digital media.